What is commissioning in construction? So this concept of commissioning, if you're anything like I was when I was starting out in my career, like it sounds scary. You're like, what is this? This sounds like this huge world. We're gonna break it down just a little bit in this video to where you have a better understanding and you can really own the process. So commissioning is tough. And if you wanna know how to control it, this video is for you. Let's go. All right, so what is commissioning? Commissioning in construction is the meticulous process of ensuring that every component and system within a building or facility functions optimally, meeting design intent and performance standards. It involves a thorough inspection, testing, and verification process to deliver a fully operational project that is efficient and one that the owners can take over seamlessly. So let me put this in Jason's terms real quick. So if you're building a building, that's just building the structure, right? So if you liken that to the human body, right, that would be like building the skeletal system and your muscles and your skin, right? But you need this thing to function, right? So now you need your nervous system, right? You need your brain, you need your circulatory system, your respiratory system, and they all have to work together. A fully commissioned Jason or human being is one where the skeletal system, your muscles, and your skin and every part of your structure also function with your nervous system, with your circulatory system, with all of the other systems that are part of the human body. I'm a commissioned human when it all works together, right? Same thing with a building. It's pretty easy to just build the building. It's hard to get it to talk to each other. It's hard to get all systems talking to each other, to power on at the right time, to work in the right sequence of operations, and to function for human occupancy. So that's basically what commissioning is. So let me take you through some steps that you can follow to really own and be able to thrive in this world of commissioning. So step one, pre-commissioning planning. So before commissioning happens, and when you do enhanced commissioning efforts, like you're really starting day, I mean, you're starting with design, right? I always say that commissioning starts day one. Like when we break ground, we start our commissioning efforts, right? So this pre-planning effort is huge. And someone is going to develop a commissioning plan outlining the project goals, scope, and responsibilities, and identify key team members and stakeholders as a part of the process. Now, typically your owner will do it or hire a commissioning agent. In rare circumstances, it will fall on you, the general contractor. But there is a pre-commissioning plan, and I would highly recommend you get used to that, read it, and basically know it as you head into this process. Two, early design review. As a part of an integrated project effort and understanding the concept of integrated systems, integrated disciplines, and the attempt to provide a design that meets those goals from a commissioning standpoint, we will want to have reviews and preferably by the commissioning agents, but basically from that perspective to make sure that the design will meet the goals or that it's possible to meet the goals. It's happened before where you can go install the systems and they don't meet the goals of the commissioning execution plan, right? We need to make sure that we're doing those design reviews. So at a minimum, you as the contractor will make sure that it's happening, whether it's from the owner, a commissioning agent, or they're using the collective expertise of the team. You're going to have to make sure that those design reviews are leading towards or having or keeping the end in mind so that we can accomplish the goals. Number three, commissioning authority selection. This is on the owner. Sometimes it's on the general contractor, but mostly it's on the owner. And you'll want to make sure, or the owner will want to make sure that an authorized and licensed commissioning authority is appointed and hired. This person will be responsible for the entire commissioning process. And the key is to make sure that this entity has the right expertise and has an unbiased perspective as they go about the commissioning process, which is key. Number four, you know it, my favorite thing, pre-construction meetings. You're going to want to make sure, especially at a minimum, reviewing the specs, bringing in those commissioning requirements, right? Those owner turnover inventory, owner training, project documentation, owner deliverable type items into the pre-construction meeting for the trade partners so that they begin with the end in mind and they're always considering commissioning. For any of the mechanical scopes, for controls, for electrical, you're probably going to want the commissioning agent there so that we can talk about that as a part of the installation. And as we get into the pre-functional checklist, functional performance testing, test and balance, and any of the other commissioning activities at the lander end of the project. We do not want to ignore those components in the pre-construction meetings. And this may be a good time to explain commissioning from a layperson's perspective. And if you're a commissioning expert out there and you're watching this video, you're probably going to be disappointed. Anybody else in construction other than a commissioning agent is going to be like, wow, this is super cool, because it is really cool. But here is the way I look at it. As you go through the construction of this building, you're going to make sure that your site utilities are coming into the building, that they're coming into your level one or basement rooms. You're going to have your service entry section, which is your main electrical room. You're going to have your main distribution frame. You're going to have your fire pump room and other rooms that bring mechanical, electrical, and plumbing services or communications into the building. Then you have chases, typically, and this is a typical building, it doesn't apply to all, but you'll have chases and electrical rooms and IDFs or independent distribution frames that will bring the MEP infrastructure, meaning the backbone, the communication systems and the devices, so that, and for MEP, some of the main lines, right? You'll have duct and hydronic piping coming up that will connect that to your mechanical rooms, which are typically on the roof. If not, you know, they could be on other floors halfway through in the basement. I get it. But you'll have to connect those entry points through chases or through pathways or overhead to those mechanical rooms or to the roof, where you typically have your air handlers and your exhaust fans, and you may even have a central utility plant. The key here is you as a contractor have got to get your mechanical, electrical, and plumbing and communications into your building, through your building, to your HVAC systems and to your mechanical systems and to your pumps as quickly as possible. So you have to schedule that properly. Then your key is, how can I get the air handlers, basically meaning your HVAC system, working as quickly as possible, especially if you have to do temporary heating or temporary cooling, which means you need to get your power up to that equipment. And you also need to get all of this equipment talking to each other, which means you're going to start to rough in your data cabling, your low voltage cabling, your structural cabling throughout the project, which means you also need your IDF rooms. And you'll want to at least put your air handlers in hand so that you can start blowing air before the system is fully commissioned. This intricate network of activities in sequence is definitely your job to manage. So you have to understand it. I always tell people, you're already probably 6 weeks behind in figuring all of this out. It's best to do all of this with the commissioning agents, because the owner and the commissioning agent aren't just going to let you use their exhaust fans and air handlers and pumps and other equipment, even some of the distribution panels in the electrical system, unless you have a really good plan. Okay, then you need to make sure you understand how fire sprinklers, fire alarm testing, the duct detectors in the duct, your test and balance effort, and everything else inside your building is going to come together for a fully operational building. On each floor, at a minimum, when you install equipment, you're going to install power, controls, wet side, dry side, and your commissioning agents are going to start to do what's called pre-functional testing. So here's how you look at it. Here are the main components. Do I have the services to the building? Do I have the services connected through the building? Do I have the equipment on the floors installed and connected? And then the controls contractor will do what's called point to point, and your commissioning agent will start doing pre-functional testing. So you need your entry, your connections, your floors, and then the system working together for you to start doing pre-functional testing, test and balance, and then functional performance testing throughout the building. So here are my layperson's terms. When you are doing equipment install, you're installing and connecting the equipment. Pre-functional testing is when your checklists are created and you basically go through any testing that can be done before the system is supposed to talk to itself and function together. Then when you do test and balance, you are doing point to point and testing the system and balancing everything so it functions properly. When you do functional performance testing, that means your sequence of operations is functioning properly and you're trying to break the system. This is huge to make sure that it's functioning properly. After that, you'll typically do something like the building flush, the documentation, your balancing reports, any of that that's required for your substantial completion. But the bottom line is, if anything I'm saying sounds foreign to you, just know it's your job to manage this, and so you have to know it, so you have to engage in this commissioning process. So let's get back to the steps here, and we'll go to number 5. The commissioning activities will need to be looped in to the specifications if they haven't already been. Number 6, construction phase commissioning activities. That's the pre-functional checklist that I was talking about. Make sure that all requirements are being checked off, inspected, and done properly as you go from a pre-functional testing standpoint, so you're ready for full-blown commissioning. When you're ready and the systems are talking to each other and you have your little black box or the brains of your building management system and you have your controls cabling and everything has been tested and you've done point-to-point on the floors and you've done point-to-point vertically throughout the building, then you're ready to make sure that all of the systems are working properly and you can start to try and break the system. These are the commissioning agents with your controls contractor. This is a key part of the phase. One big tip that I will give you here is when you're doing test and balance, make sure that you carefully integrate the testing of your fire alarm system, or else they will really conflict and you won't have a really nice testing experience. Number 8, the systems manual development. This is where comprehensive systems manuals are developed for the operation of the systems themselves. Your end users will use these to operate the building. They must be developed and they are part of your project turnover, your deliverables, and will be a part of your owner training. 9, the training process with the end users. This is crucial. This takes a really nice touch, meaning we have to get the right people in the right room and we have to make these trainings really engaging and valuable and relevant, and we should record them for future use. So there's a chuck it over the wall type of owner training that we don't want to do. Then there's the really engaged partnering. Let's have really meaningful engagements with the right people doing the right training. Record it, document it, transmit it in the right way. Once your building has been commissioned and all of the corrective actions have been corrected and all final inspections are done and you have your preliminary balancing report and you have achieved your substantial completion, then it is time for you to do post-occupancy monitoring. This is where you track the performance of the systems and make any needed corrections. After that, the commissioning agent will do any final commissioning, final functional performance testing, verify any corrective actions are complete, and will deliver the final commissioning report. Then step number 12 is closeout and handover, where you deliver all of those documents and the building is ready and functioning properly, and you can hand that over to the owner. And so I know this has been a lot. I know this is a long video, but this is crucial. Here are some tips and tricks for you as you're learning this system. Number 1, you're already 6 weeks behind. You need to engage the commissioning meetings. You need to engage the commissioning agent. You need to start some of these inspections 6 weeks earlier than you are currently planning. I promise you that's right. Number 2, the lead superintendent needs to be all over this, needs to understand all of this and be asking the questions and manage this system. It cannot be delegated. 3, all of this has to be tied into your project schedule, especially your systems infrastructure, your points of entry in the building, your chases and vertical infrastructures, which I call them, all of your systems and equipment, your point-to-point on each floor, your point-to-point through the building, your test and balance, your functional performance testing, and your building flush all need to be in the schedule, in addition to any life safety testing and fire alarm testing. Number 4, when you put it into your schedule, you need to understand how they all interact so that you can orchestrate the right sequence and not get into trouble. And number 5, be in every commissioning meeting, make real good friends with your inspectors and with the commissioning agent and partner with them as you go, and you'll be just fine. The key is this. If you're like, whoa, Jason, that was a lot. All you need to know is start sooner and ask a lot of questions and make sure you're proactive. If you do that, you're going to be fine. And so I'm going to link you to 2 things. 1, a summarized blog post of this information. And 2, I'm going to give you a mural board that shows the activities that you need to be mindful of when you're creating your project schedule and that you need to monitor as a part of your project. This was just an overview. If you want more, please comment below and connect with me and we'll do a training. I'll link you to some other resources. I'll connect you with some cool people. But the bottom line is commissioning is your responsibility. I wish you the best of luck. On we go.